Welcome everybody. Today we will discuss some important characteristics of linear IC. Linear IC operates in two range. One is linear range, another is saturated range. I will tell the difference. Suppose you have this IC and arrange IC like this. It is something like unit gain operation where when you are giving a sine wave as a input, the output also should come like sine wave. Then it is linear range. In case of saturation range, saturated range, output becomes like this. Output becomes a square wave. Output will go either positive or negative, depending on the input voltage. Input is positive, output will go positive. Input is negative, output will go negative. So today we are talking about the linear range. This is linear range. This is saturated range. Today we are talking about the linear range of amplifier. Now, suppose this is IC. Now, IC characteristics such that the positive terminal dominates. Means whatever voltage you will give to positive terminal, say plus 5 volt, this terminal also will become plus 5 volt, same voltage. If you give minus 7 volt, this also will become minus 7 volt. You are free to give any voltage within linear range to plus terminal but not negative terminal. Negative terminal follows the positive terminal as long as IC is linear range. If IC is not a linear range, this voltage will not follow this, both will be different. I will show some examples. See, this is first example. Here positive terminal I have given plus 5 volt. Because it has to be linear, we are talking about linear range. This negative voltage, negative terminal voltage also will become plus 5. What is this? And I have given 2 volt here. This combination is not correct. Here plus 5, here 2. So this is wrong. This will not operate a linear range, it will go to saturation. Similarly here. This is similar to this. Only thing, I have added one resistor. Here also it will not operate. This negative terminal will follow positive terminal voltage, that is plus 5 volt. This is one example. I connected 2 volt, this resistor, so current has to flow in this voltage, and this voltage will not be equal, it will go to saturation range. Second characteristic of this linear IC is that no current is allowed to flow in this negative terminal. If circuit is operating in linear range, circuit combination should be such that the current should not flow in the negative terminal. If current is not flowing in the negative terminal, it is sure to go to saturation mode. Third example is this. This is correct application. We have given the plus 5 volt here. This negative terminal becomes plus 5 volt. I have given 7 volt here, there is a resistance because across resistance there is a voltage difference, current will flow, but there is a current path. So current will go like this and it will operate in the linear range. So this resistance is must to operate the IC in linear range. If this is not there, it will go to saturation mode. Why this is essential? Now you know. Because if this is not there, current will flow. This voltage will not be equal to this voltage and it will go to saturation mode. Okay, and this circuit arrangement is very common, everybody knows. The gain of the out operation amplifier will be this resistance divided by this resistance and plus this voltage. Now let us come to slew rate. This is the third characteristic, important characteristic of linear IC. I will explain why. Suppose this is IC. okay, and operating in unit case. Now I have given a square wave as a square wave. The output should follow like this, but in reality it is not like that because of slow rot. Output is not very fast, it is slow. Output will go like this, little slow. The input is like this, output is like this. For example, for linear IC 741, slew rate is 0.5 volt per microsecond. So rate of rise of the signal will be 0.5 volt per microsecond. That too, if no load is connected. If you connect some capacitor, depending on the capacitor value, this will come for the slow. Now here itself you see, instead of taking this much voltage, suppose your input is only this much. You will get a better quality of output. It is not becoming faster, it is looking faster because your signal is small. Small signal will give better. Or you have to reduce the frequency. Suppose frequency is very high, say like this. Because of slew rate, voltage will start from here, it will not reach here. It will stop here and voltage come down, it will go like this. You will get something like triangular wave shape. So linear IC operate above certain frequency only because of many reasons. One of them is slow rate. So this frequency has to be slower, otherwise you will not get proper output. Okay. Today only that much. Thank you very much.